We are live now, Rimika. You can start.
Hello and good afternoon, everyone. Sorry for the delay. There was some technical glitches. This is Rimika, and on behalf of our team, I would like to welcome you all. Starting with short intro of our program, which has been conducted by our Optum team, where we discuss and interact about optometry-related topics. As it's live, if you have any queries, you can type them out in conversation box and we will be discussing them after the presentation. Today, we have Mr. Ashish Acharya, who is going to talk about absorptive lenses. Before starting the session, I would like to introduce Mr. Ashish Acharya among all. He did his bachelor's in optometry from NSHM. He is currently working as consultant optometrist at Drishti Eye Care. He is also CEO of Vision Eye Care Division, a unit of Drishti Eye Care System. So, on behalf of For Optum team, I would like to welcome you, sir. Over to you.
Yeah, thank you so much. So, thank you for the introduction. It's not Vision Eye Care Division, it's Vision Care Division. So it was a good introduction, in fact. So thank you so much for this opportunity for Optum. I really appreciate the initiation taken by the For Optum so far, and I'm also very good fan of you guys, whatever you have done so far. So I tried to make this topic, absorptive lenses, a little bit elaborative, actually, because what we talk most about the UV only and a few tinted lenses only. So I tried to cover as much as possible. So I'll, without any delay, I'll just like to go in the presentation. So what are the absorptive lenses? These are the lenses basically used to regulate or to reduce the amount of the light transmitted from it. So any lenses which is used for the specific purpose of reducing the amount of the light that will be transmitted are called as the absorptive lenses. So basically there are four types of the absorptive lenses that I'll be discussing about. So one is tinted lenses, another is photochromatic lenses, another is polaroid lenses, and the special filters that I'll be talking about, which will be used in the low vision cases especially. So first we'll go with the light spectrum. We know that light contains visible and invisible light. So we all know that visible light ranges from 380 to 760 nanometer, and anything above the 760 nanometers falls under the infrared radiation, that is above red radiations, and then whatever falls under violet is called as ultraviolet radiations. Okay, so we know that the ultraviolet, further it is divided into three types, but we have not discussed much about the infrared. So I'll talk about the infrared radiations as well. So infrared radiations is the radiations that is above the red spectrum of the light. Actually categorized into three part: infrared radiation, infrared A, B, and C. So A is also called as near infrared, B is also known as mid, and C is also called as far infrared. You can see the reference where it has been like categorized. So you can see 760 to 1400 nanometer falls under the infrared radiations A. Similarly, above means 3000 to 1 mm, 3000 nanometer to 1 mm falls under the infrared radiation C. But as UVC is not reached to the earth, similarly, even the infrared radiation C is absorbed by the atmosphere. So infrared radiation C won't come to us, actually. So we'll be exposed only to the infrared radiation A and B. So here we can see that how the infrared radiations are absorbed from our ocular tissue. So we can see only the little part of the infrared radiations A, that is like infrared A, which is also called as infrared, near infrared, will be reaching to the retina, which can cause the damage to the retina. Okay, so most of the other infrared will be absorbed by our ocular tissues like iris, and then lenses, lens cornea, etc. Okay, so what are the ocular damages that can be caused by the infrared radiation? So the most common one we know is like the solar retinopathy. So which is a solar retinitis. So which is the like a mixture of infrared radiations, blue light, and then ultraviolet, which is a damage caused by the infrared radiations where there is an intense amount of the infrared radiation. So what infrared radiation does is like it causes mostly the thermal effect. It causes the thermal effect, and which causes the enzyme denaturation in the cellular level. So if you see the cornea, there will be the loss of the transparency or the opacification. You can see it in the corneal edge. Sometimes there can be flare in the aqueous humor, and iris is mostly affected because there are the pigments which will cause the absorption of the most of the infrared radiations, and which can cause the swelling and cell death in the iris cells. Pupillary miasis is one of the caused due to the infrared radiations. It can cause the hyperemia in the iris and inflammations also, so which can cause the flare, as I told you. Lenses, there is like multifactorial cause of the cataract, among which one is like UV, which is always playing a vital role, and another is infrared as well, and there are other disease condition also which plays a role in the cataract formation. As you all know, like mostly the blur cataract will be formed due to the infrared radiations. So in the vitreous, so there can be sometime haze, even that can be because of this iris tissues which will be in the backside, and then retina, there can be edema, bones. So there can be the dispigmentation also in the retinal level. And now talking about the ultraviolet ray, we all know that ultraviolet ray itself is like further divided into three categories, that is UVA, UVB, and UVC. And we all know that the shorter the wavelength, the stronger it is, and which causes more damage to our ocular structure, even the skin and everything. But even we are lucky that the ultraviolet C, in which the 200 to 200 nanometer that wavelength falls of the UV are mostly absorbed by the ozone layer, and there is a good news in the pandemic era that it is even more healed. So now I think like even UVC won't be coming even in future days. So we are only victim of UVB and UVA, and frankly speaking, UVA is very relatively less harmful, and UVA is mostly responsible for causing the skin tan, discoloration of the skin. Okay, and as you all know, it has the longest wavelength among all the UV, so it is least harmful in all the UV. Okay, and even we can see here that solar UV radiations comprises of the 95% of UVA and 5% of the UVB. As I told, UVC won't be coming to us. Okay, so UVB, here we can see the wavelength, that is 290 to 350 nanometers. So shorter the wavelength, we know that higher the energy than the UVA. So it is mainly responsible for the sunburn, photokeratitis, cataract, and the retinal lesion also. But it is the retinal lesion, cataract are always known to be the multifactorial cause. You cannot only say that it is because of only UV, or it's only because of infrared, or it's only because of any diseases, okay, systemic diseases. So actually, there's a fact that only 1% of the incident UV actually reaches to the retina. Most of the UV will be absorbed by our other ocular structures like cornea, like lens, iris, and others. Okay, so what happens is like when there is the higher absorption of the UV from the ocular structures, then there is like direct, it is linked with the cellular level. Okay, so what it causes is like there is a high tryptophan content in the stromal protein, so it causes a high ascorbic acid concentration of the epithelium and the absorbance of the ultraviolet radiations directly by the nucleic acid. Okay, so in the cellular level, how it does, we'll talk in the next slide also. So UVC, as it is filtered, so we don't need to worry much about, but there are some artificial sources of the UVC, like arc welding. So we can see sometimes the patient with like photophthalmia, those patients who are exposed to the welding, primarily in the welding arc for a long time. They will be like having a severe photophobia, watering, redness. So these all are the artificial sources of the UVC. If we'll even not take care of that, that can cause the ocular surface damage, like even there sometimes the epithelium of the cornea gets clogged up. Okay, and there is something called as UVC sterilizing lamps also, which is also emitting the UVC. Though the UV is not coming from the solar system, but it can be artificially produced as well, as I told, by the most commonly we can find it in the arc welding. Okay, so when we are even get, we can tell our patients that even getting longer exposure to the welding can cause this photophthalmia for those patients, and can cause the harm in the eye. Okay, so what happens is like there are multiple things that can happen. There can be the protein cross-linking in the cellular level. Apoptosis can be happening. We know that apoptosis is a like programmed cell death, and there can be the membrane damage of the cell, dysfunction of the enzyme, and direct DNA damage, as I told. So these are the like mechanism how the UV causes damage to our eye in the different cellular level and in the different structure. So according to the structure, we can see that the eyelid, in the eyelid, UV is mainly responsible for the skin malignancies. Also, so the most common is like basal cell carcinoma and the squamous cell carcinoma, which is also due to mainly due to the UVB. Okay, it's not UVA, it's UVB. And the lenses, the cataract can be formed as a, but as I told, you cannot tell that cataract is only because of UV or only because of infrared. It can be the combination of both. And the retina, there is always like the chances of getting ARMD in the retina due to the UV exposure, and even here also infrared radiations is mixed. Okay, so if we talk about the lenses which can block the UV rays, which lenses that all block the UV rays, we need to know what are the ophthalmic lenses that blocks the UV rays. So first thing is like any lenses that have the material that blocks the UV rays, like high index, all the high index lenses like above 1.6, the lenses will definitely block the UV. Polycarbonate is a good lens which can block the UV, though it doesn't have the good optical property in the ophthalmic lenses, but polycarbonate does the protection of the UV from the UV to our eyes. Okay, so any lenses that will be coated with a UV filter, like previously some companies used to do that, and the coating of the lenses can be done in the front and the back so that it will either like means repel the UV from the lenses. And there can be some dye used which can also cause the UV filter. Polarized lenses are always UV protective lenses. So any polarized lens, if it is a polarized lens, you can definitely tell it is a UV protection. Okay, 100%. And photochromatic lenses, but not in the means lighter stage, but in the darker state, when it is means exposed in the UV and it turns into the dark, then it is a good source of the UV protection and UV absorber. And there are other special filters like NOAIR, CPF. I'll be talking about that in the future slide. So these all lenses, you can take a screenshot and see, like these all lenses will act as a UV protection. Okay, so it's not like only the this lens or that lens does the UV protection. Like in the means I deal with the ZEISS, so there is like an inbuilt property in the material itself. There is a blocking of the UV rays. So in other companies, it can be a coating form. Any lenses that is like which is means having the higher index, or any lenses which is made of the polycarbonate, is always a UV protective lenses. And as I told, like there can coating can be applied, and all the lenses that is tinted. Okay, so even the tinted, if it is a good dye used, then it is a good UV protector, or it can act as a UV filter as well. Okay, so now I'll talking about the glare. What is the glare? Glare is means we all know that it's the contrast lowering effect of the exterior light in the visual scene. Anything that we see which causes the effect in the contrast, which means hinder our visibility, and means when we cannot discriminate between the objects, two objects, then the light is the history of the light is known as the glare. Okay, so there are different form I have taken. I mean, somewhere we can see that there is like disabling glare and distracting glare. Somewhere it is four. So I try to take as much as possible. So distracting glare is something like that cause only a minor distraction, which is caused by the light reflected off the lens surfaces, which are not like UV, anti-reflection coated lenses, and those are especially like hard coat and on coat lenses. What happens is like there is the internal lens reflection occurs, which can cause the ghost images which you can see in front of your eyes. Okay, so you must know, means there must be many students of the optometry and ophthalmic assistant here, so you must know that there are reflection happens in the, from the different surfaces of the lens. There are five different types of the reflection that occurs in the lenses. So if there is an internal lens reflections occur, then at that time ghost image may be formed, which can cause the distraction. And most common is the back side of the lens surface, because it acts as a concave mirror, and you can sometimes see your own eye. Okay, so that's really means annoying and distracting. So this can be eliminated only by the anti-reflection coating. Okay, so what it causes, like sometimes the confusion, and even it can cause the eye fatigue. So this is the reason why you give a like anti-reflection coated lenses for the computer users and all who use a computer for a long time. There is another glare called as discomfort. It usually it do not creates you difficulty in like what you call see the contour, but what it causes is like difficulty in adjusting the lighting and the non-lighting condition. Like if you are sitting in front of a, means if you are sitting in a room where there is, in the beside there is a window where the intense light is coming, so at that time you may be finding the glare problem. Okay, so it is mainly related to the visual comfort, but not the resolution. You can you can see the image, but it is about the comfort that you can, you won't be the comfortable. So even for the computer vision syndrome, which is one of the cause of the computer vision syndrome, is the discomfort glare, which is caused due to the inequality in the brightness in the room. Also, even outside when there is an intense amount of the sunlight, you can see here. So these all relate to the comfort of our eye. It doesn't hamper to the resolution, though means eye fatigue can be occurred. As I have written here, like even the viewing television in the darker room, working in the computer screen in the front of the bright window, even sometime like if there is a source of the light, any LED in front of you, not overhead but in front of you, it can cause discomfort in a long time. Okay, so you need to take care of those things also. So this is the discomfort glare. Okay, so how we can eliminate this, means in the window, like you can put the curtains and all the vertical blends and all, like you can make the contrast, means sorry, brightness adjusted of your computer and your room by the computer and the room lighting, and while going outside you can use simply what tinted lenses or photochromatic lenses as well. Okay, there is something called as disability glare. So as name itself, so disability glares occurs when the history of the light interferes with the contrast, make it difficult to resolve an image. So you will find difficulty even in resolving a image. You cannot see your image properly. So it washes out the details and the contrast as well. So if a person is like already having a cataract or any opacity in the ocular media, like corneal opacity, even due to the light dispersion, the condition can be even worsened. So a person who has having cataract, that's why we suggest you, if he's not going for the surgery immediately, then you need to think upon the photochromatic lenses or polarized lenses or at least a tinted lenses, so that patients can be little comfortable while going in the sunlight, where there can be a chances of having this disability glare. Okay, and there is something called as a blinding glare. So blinding glare is something which completely make you blind for a while. Means what, when it happens is like it can happen in the snow, for the skiing, during the skiing, even in the water sometime, and even you can see in the sand also. So it can block the vision completely. So the best way to eliminate this is the polarized lenses. Okay, so we'll be talking about those lenses also. Now I'll go to the objective lenses. So in the objective lenses, I'll talk about the tinted lenses. So how the tinted lenses are manufactured. Previously we used to use the glasses tinted lenses. So nowadays there is what you call organic means plastic tinted lenses. Okay, so these lenses are simply made tinted by dipping it into the organic dye. Okay, so appropriate organic dye according to your color desired, according to the like intensity, how gradient you need, how dark you need, you can just make that what you call solution warmer, and then you can dip it into that solution. The longer you dip, the more darker it will become. Okay, so this is a very simple process. Even locally you can manufacture this, but the lenses should not be hard coated both sides, should be uncoated in one side. So what most of the manufacturing company does is like they make the lenses uncoat first, then they do the tinting, and then they do the other coatings like hard coating, ARC coating and so on. Okay, so plastic lenses are very easy to make the tinted, as in the market is readily available organic dyes. Okay, but you need to assure that that is a good organic dye, and you need to check either whether the UV is getting means blocked by that tinted lens or not. Okay, in the glass material, as you all know, there previously the oxides used to be like used for the different colors, but nowadays this is not the condition is already obsolete, so I won't be talking much about this. But for a student, you must know that previously the metallic oxide used to be like mixed with the lenses in glass, that is I'm calling talking about the mineral lenses. So there it used to be mixed and the color used to be produced. Like you can see here, red will be made by gold, definitely. Okay, so according to the material of the oxide, then it will give the tint to those lenses. But nowadays, as the plastic lenses has taken over the market, so you don't need to know much about this glass material. And how do they do the tinted lenses? They either reduce the intensity of the light, or they either transmit or block the specific wavelength. So we'll be talking about this as well. Tinted lenses absorb the UV. If it's a good organic dye, even it absorbs the infrared light, okay? And it responds to the ambient light, level of the light, reduce the surface reflections, but the coating should be there. And some tinted lenses work as a good enhancing for the contrast. Okay, so we'll be talking about that. So tinted lenses for the different ocular conditions like ARMD, retinitis pigmentosa, a lot of low vision cases actually, like oculocutaneous albinism, cone dystrophy, even the diabetic retinopathy in the advanced stage, and cataract, as I told you, like as there will be, they will have glare in the intense light conditions due to the light dispersion. So these are the mainly ideal conditions where you should always think of the tinted lenses, or these all adaptive lenses. So different color of the tinted use in the ophthalmic lenses. So I'll be talking about this now. Talk about the green tint. So in the green tint, it is like it is also called as a, like a very soothing color. So it can be used for the general purpose. It dims the glare while brightening the means shadows and transmits all the color evenly. Okay, so it can be also used as a neutral color as well. Brown means even brown cause the evenness in the transmission through whole visible spectrum, so it allows the color to be perceived in the natural state. Okay, so means there are a lot of the occupation where you need to perceive the color of a object in the natural state or the neutral state, whatever they are. Okay, so it can be used in that condition. It can improve the depth perception as well, and the brown. So there are some occupation where you need more depth perception, and good for variable everyday condition also. Like brown is considered for evergreen color. Like most of the you can see in the most of the sunglasses are in either gray or brown. Okay, so yellow is always we all know that yellow enhances the contrast and the depth perception as well. So a lot of athletes use this in the shooting also. It is used because the contrast it enhances. And another interesting fact is, like, if you use the yellow light while yellow tint while using the computer, it is a good means absorber of the blue lights as well. Okay, so if you want to use the, means any blue cut lenses, so even the yellow tinted lenses are also will be acting as a blue light blue cut lenses. Okay, so because it means absorbs all the low wavelength lights, and as we all know, like, means blue falls under the lower means Bevier pattern, and it provides greater clarity in the fog, haze, and other low light conditions. So some people are selling it as a night driving, but it is not very proven that it helps in the night. But when we talk about the subjective response, most of the customer finds that their contrast is enhanced in the night. Okay, so you need to ask the customer while giving those night driving yellow tinted lenses whether you are feeling comfortable or not, because see, any tinted lenses can absorb the light even in the night time. It will cause the absorption of the light, and it will filter and passes less amount of the light. It can cause even more darker. Okay, but what customer feels, if they feels like it is okay, contrast is enhanced, you can give them in depending upon the subjective response. But it is not proven that yellow will definitely help you in the night driving and all. Okay, and there is another tint like blue or purple, which is also a neutral color perception for the neutral purple neutral color perception, and for the golf player and all, they highly use blue or purple color tinted lenses. And even for the aesthetic purpose, for the like women, they prefer the purple color tinted lenses, and it even enhances the color perception as well. Okay, and gray and black are like ideal for using outdoor for in the intense light conditions. It reduces the eye fatigue, provides the true color perception. And if it is dark enough, it is means it's even like protective for the infrared also. Other lenses, whatever I talked, other tints, means these tints, yellow and all, they do not cause the blockage of the infrared, but gray or black, if they are in the enough intensity, then they also cause the infrared radiations protection as well. Okay, and even it causes the reduction in the glare, especially off water, these two gray or black color tinted lenses. Okay, pink and red, as I told you, like it caused the as yellow, it also works as a improvement in the depth perception, and it provides a good road visibility. And it is thought like for the neurological condition, pink and red is the ideal condition, ideal tint to be used. Okay, and it is also known to be reducing in the eye strain. Okay, so if we want to summarize it, green can be used for the neutral color perception and for the general purpose. Yellow can be used in the condition where we need a lot of improvement in the contrast, like shooting or in the fog condition, in the night condition, because it thought to be acting as a good road visibility. Brown, it can be used for the neutral color perception and for the general purpose as well. Okay, and it also enhances the depth perception for those occupation which needs the higher depth perception. Red, pink, as I told, it again helps in the improving the contrast. Gray, black is for good color perception, and if you want a complete like protection from the infrared and UV, gray and black is the most ideal one. Okay, and blue, as you told, like if you want to see the contour of anything, like if your occupation wants something that need to see the contour of anything very clearly, then blue is recommended on that time. Okay, so here this I have taken from a framedirect.com, where you can see is like which all tints are like ideal for which conditions. Here you can see brown or gray, as I told, or pink can be used in a sunny condition, partial cloudy, which all things can be used in a foggy, low light and snow condition as well. Okay, you can take a screenshot of this. I won't be going much details on this. So here also you can see that for the computer or gaming, you can use the yellow light. Why? Because yellow tint, because it absorbs the blue light, okay, that will be coming out from the computer or mobiles. Okay, so here you can see the use of the different tints for the different your activities, day by day activities. Even here you can see what according to your sports, it is different tints are recommended. Okay, so you can take the reference of this as well. So how much tint is enough? Okay, so in the ordinary, sunglasses transmits around 15 to 30% of the total light. So a sun lenses that transmit more than 30% may not be helpful in the average way, whether enough in the full sunlight. Okay, so sunlight that transmit less than 50% may present problem because of the reflected glare from the back surface, which need anti-reflection coating lenses. Okay, and for the driving, it should not be less than 8%. And so the transmission should be high, and the skin mountain climbing may go up to less than 3%. Okay, because there is an intense amount of the source of the light, and ideal is always around 10 to 12% of the transmission of the light. Okay, so it depends upon your circumstances. Now we'll talk about the photochromatic lenses. So as you know, photochromatic, the word itself is derived from the Greek word light. Photos means light and chroma means color. So there anything that responds to the color, responds to the light, any change in the color is response to the light. So how it is produced? Okay, so glass photochromatic, again it is already obsolete. Glass is not much used, but we need to know previously, like silver halide used to be mixed with the minerals, and then when it was exposed to the UV or blue light of the visible spectrum, then it used to get breaks into the silver and halogen, and it used to get tones into the dark stage. So for the plastic photochromatic, there is another molecule nowadays used. So this is widely used, this spiroindoline molecules. So it is again the same phenomena when it is exposed to the UV or blue light of the visible spectrum, 300 to 400 nanometer. So the spiroindoline molecules get scattered in your lens surface, and it turns darker. Okay, so this is the manufacturing of the plastic photochromatic lenses. So means it is the amount of the photo darkening of the photochromatic lenses depends upon some things like in the temperature. It's really surprising when the temperature is more, the darkness darker and the darker stage will be less. Okay, we need to remember this. If the UV exposure is good, but if the temperature is too high, then the lens won't be as dark as when it will be in the little colder stage. Okay, so you need to know that only due to the warm weather, the light, the photochromatic lenses won't turn dark. There should be the enough UV exposure or UV also present. And if you compare any cloudy days, when the temperature won't be much higher, but if the UV is in the good amount, then the light will get turn darker more faster. Okay, and even the thickness, the more the thick the lenses, it will be more darker, and definitely new lenses turns darker within less time, more time than the old lenses. Means there is something called as the memory of the lenses. When the lenses will be exposed to the UV for a long time, like let's say 2 months, 3 months, then it will turn darker fastly, because it will have a memory that means because of the exposure in the UV for a longer time. Okay, so now we're talking about the polarized lenses. So we all know that the polarization is the process of transforming unpolarized light into the polarized light. Okay, so how the polarized lenses is made, we can simply see here. So role of the polyvinyl alcohol will be like staged here and heated and staged, you can see here. So what happens is like it is staged 5 times then its normal length, and it is dipped into the iodine bath solution. You can see, okay, polyvinyl alcohol roll is there. So it is staged and it is then dipped into the iodine bath, and there will be two like roll of the cap. Okay, so so you must know the fulpa cap, cellulose acetate butyrate. So it will be like sandwiched between two roll of the cap, and then finally the polarized lenses which will be sandwiched and will be formed. Okay, so you can, so always you need to know that polarized lenses are never transparent. It should have any tint with it. Okay, that is always, polarized lenses are always tinted lenses. It cannot be a clear lenses, transparent lenses. So how it works is like the lights that coming from the sunlight, it is like unpolarized light, and we all know that it is in the it is vibrating in the multi direction. So when it is like reflected from any horizontal plane surface, what happens is like the horizontal plane, it will be like partially polarized. Okay, some unpolarized light will be there, but it will be partially polarized into the horizontal plane. You can see here. So our eyes means feel more annoying in the horizontal polarized light. So what it does is like polarized lens make the horizontal and other unpolarized light into the vertical polarized light. So our eyes see more, eyes is more friendly with the vertically polarized light and unpolarized light rather than the horizontal polarized light. So those which are horizontally plane polarized will be filtered and then passed as a vertical polarized or unpolarized light. So how it works is like means any, already it is unpolarized when it's in the like air, but when it get strike into any surface like water or mirror or anything, then what happens is like the horizontal polarized light and partially horizontal polarized light and partially unpolarized light will enter through it, and then the horizontal polarized light will be totally blocked, and only the vertical polarized light will be allowed to pass to our eyes, where eyes is very comfortable. Okay, so you can see here how the vertical blend like image, you can see how it works. Okay, so it, you can see as a bar of the vertical oriented bar. Okay, so UV for the polarized lenses is always the best for high amount of intensity of the light, and to reduce the glare, the best thing is to use is the polarized light. And for the UV protection, there is always 100% UV protection incorporated in the polarized lenses, as because it's tinted also, and it is widely used while using, means while water sports or fishing or skiing or anything where there is an intense veil of the light will be there, and it's also helpful for reducing the eye strain. Okay, and for the better vision also. But polarized lenses are not recommended while using LEDs or mobiles or like while in the you are, I mean, if you are a pilot or for some occupation like that. Okay, and there are some special filters Also, which are used mostly in the low vision conditions. One, I will talk about the glare control, CPF. CPF means Corning photochromatic lenses. So it is a lenses which where you can see, like for the CPF 27, there are different numbers of the CPF. Okay, so the number defines the wavelength of the light up to which it will absorb. Okay, you will see here CPF 40 is there, CPF 511 is there, CPF 527 is there. So according to the number, it cut off the wavelength up to that number. Okay, so it denotes that. And these all are like photochromatic lenses, so it turns darker when it is exposed to the UV. Okay, so you can see here means how the these all things work and how much darker it will become when it is exposed to the UV radiations. Okay, and here you can see means for which purpose it is used, like CPF 450, you can see reading, television. So purpose is also written in the right side of the slide. Okay, and there is something called as the Noir filters also. So according to the manufacturer of the marketing literature of theirs, like the UV shields provide the protection for 100% UV. This UV shield and both Noir filters are manufactured by the Noir. Okay, so and Noir filter is supposed to be blocking both infrared as well as UV. Okay, so as I told you, not all the lenses blocks the infrared and the UV. Many blocks the UV, but Noir filter especially blocks the infrared as well, where there might be chances of the thermal burn in the retina, like might be in the albinism cases. Okay, where already the retina is like compromised. At that condition, you need to give both protection, UV as well as infrared. So at that time, the Noir filter can be the best option for you to use. Okay, so there are some articles where there are different results. Okay, so do the tinted lenses or the filters improve the visual acuity performance in the low vision? So it's a very good article where you can see like there is a mix of the response, but in most of the results you can see the visual acuity and then contrast is increased after use of the these all filters. Okay, Noir filters and these all CPF filters and all. So but we always need to consider the subjective response of the patient for those low vision conditions. So this depends upon the low vision condition patient's response as well. You need to do subjectively also how good they are feeling, while using computer inside the room, how good they feel. So according to the subjective response also, you need to prescribe them. And if the visual acuity is improving, definitely means it can help those low vision patient a lot. Okay, so so the objective lenses, what are the special consideration that we need to do while giving the means objective lenses the patients for the albinism, road cone dystrophy, and as I told in the cataract, there can be glare for those who are FAKs, where there's no lens, crystalline lens to absorb the UV, or infrared pseudophakic lenses. Also, you need to think about the adjective lenses. Patient with pinguicula, pterygium, BSK, okay, band-shaped keratopathy. These all are more prone to get worsen in the exposure of the UV and the infrared. Okay, so for the sports lover, there is an intense amount of the UV exposed in the mountain and in the hilly area and in the snow. So those patients who are taking drugs like diuretic, antibiotic and contraceptive, actually those patients are more prone to get the sunburn and skin cancer. So these all patients who are taking these drugs like diuretic, antibiotic for a longer time. Okay, for those also the adjective lenses are recommended. For the children especially who plays outside, because the children's crystalline lens is not fully UV absorber, so at that time you need to think upon the adjective lenses for their eyes protection. For the dentist, welders, okay, where there will be artificial source of the these all radiations exposure will be there, and as I told, like the low vision patient. So these are the ideal conditions where you need to think upon the objective lenses especially. So if I want to conclude that infrared and the UV both has its adverse effect in the ocular tissues, and the children and elderly people with the cataract operation operated need more means protection from the UV and the infrared, obviously, because child, their crystalline lens are not fully mature to absorb all the harmful radiations, and even for the elder age where the cataract cataractous lenses causes more what you call dispersion of the light and causes the reduction in the visual acuity and contrast as well. So we must select appropriate tint or absorptive lenses for the, depending upon the occupation and the circumstances. As I told, like some are good for enhancing the contour, some are good for enhancing the contrast, some are good for other purposes as well. So you need to think upon the occupation of the customer as well, and depending upon that, you need to consider the different type of the tint or different color of the tint to be used. And special filters should be always think for the patients with the low vision conditions, and it should be always, as I told, depend upon the subjective response. So thank you so much. So if there will be any questions, I'll be happy to share or happy to answer. Thank you.
That was a wonderful presentation, sir. And I'm sure our audience have also enjoyed it. So let's move to the discussion. Shall I read the question, sir?
So I can see the questions.
Do you want me to read, or you will?
Or if you want to, so I will know that about the question. Means I can see anything apart from my screen. I means my whatever I'm sharing.
Okay, sir. Arvind Kumar is asking that, can you briefly explain about ghost image once again?
No, ghost image is like the image that will be formed basically due to the internal light reflections happen between the lens surface. Okay, so lens has its front surface, its back surface. So if you know, the there are the different type of the light reflections happen. So if the light will go, light is only not passing from the front of our eyes, means it sometimes come from our back of our back of the lenses also, back side of our body also. So when that happens, like light can be reflecting from back surface of the lens, or it can be internally reflect, okay, in between the lens surfaces of the front and back, and it can cause the images that ghost image are the false images, but you can perceive this because of those reflections. And even sometimes it is like known that the ghost images is even happening during this night driving time also.
Thank you for the answer, sir. Moving to the next question, which occupations should compulsory use absorptive lenses?
Absorptive lenses?
Yes, sir.
So if we talk about the absorptive lenses, like what I recommend is like whoever is using outdoors, okay, so whoever go outdoor and like work outdoor, like the marketing people who need to go outside a lot. So those people are definitely need the absorptive lenses, where there will be longer exposure to the natural source of the light, that is sunlight. For those who walks indoor, might be only the yellow tinted lenses they can use, or blue filter or blue cord lenses they can use. But for those who need to go outside and you need to stay outside for a longer time, actually they are the best ideal candidate to be used for the absorptive lenses.
Mr. Ajit Thakur asks, how can we judge the transmittance of ordinary sunglass, or it is just subjective choice of patient?
Pardon, can you please repeat the question?
How can we judge the transmittance of ordinary sunglass, or it is just subjective choice of patient?
Yeah, means it actually depends upon the subjective choice of the patients only, because we cannot judge that transmitted light, means how much it is getting transmitted. It's a good question, Ajit sir. So we cannot judge that actually so far.
Mr. Ajit Thakur again asks, can any clinical or occupational criteria for prescribing of absorptive or fixed tints or photochromatic glasses?
Pardon, can you repeat?
Any clinical or occupational criteria for prescription of absorptive or fixed tint lenses or photochromatic glasses?
So any, what you called, means can you please repeat, any fixed,
any clinical or occupational criteria
for, okay, prescription, so Yeah, so occupational criteria, like there are some occupations, like for the sports, I think there are fixed for the golf player. I think there is a fixed tint, and even for these shooters and for the shooters also, I think there is a fixed tint. I don't know the what is the amount of the tint, but there is a fixed tint. And even I saw I've shown there, like for the low vision patients. Okay, so even in the low vision patients, there are the fixed tint that is used, but that is only available in these or Noirs and all branded filters, where there will be like fixed tints, and it will be mentioned also how much it will be absorbing and how much it will be like passing. So those two things I know so far. There might be other clinical applications as well for this absorptive lenses and the photochromatic lenses. So photochromatic lenses, as I told, like photochromatic lenses is day-to-day thing, is like is best for those candidates who has to switch from indoor and outdoor. Okay, who is only exposed to the outdoor, photochromatic won't be a good choice, because absorptive lenses or fixed tinted lenses are a good choice. But those patients who need to switch, means sometimes need to go inside and sometimes need to go outside. For those patients with the single lenses, if they want to walk, then those people are the ideal candidate in the even in the occupation to use the photochromatic lenses.
Mr. Arvind Kumar asks, do you suggest protective absorptive glasses before cataract surgery?
Yeah, definitely, because like, see, when you use photochromatic lenses or any tinted lenses, definitely it has the UV absorber, or it will block the UV, as well as if you use, as I told, like gray or black lenses, then it is a good blocker of infrared as well, which are the main causative of the cataract. So definitely, if a patient uses it, those who are working for outdoors, okay, though, like some occupations, and they need to go, they need to spend a lot of time in outdoors. So even for the players also, so for those, definitely it is recommended before cataract. And even after cataract, as I told, like there won't be the crystalline lens to absorb. The, after cataract, it is highly recommended to use the absorptive or at least photochromatic, as because when we go outside, then the it turns darker and it will be acting as a good source of UV blocker.
Mr. Manish Chaudhary asks, what is the general difference between Polaroid and absorptive lenses?
So see, the, there is different things, like means absorptive lenses works in the principle of like absorbing the means lens, means light. Okay, so the amount of the tint you use, the intensity of the tint you use, the regulations of the light depends upon that. If you use like intense amount of the tint, and it, if it is too darker, then it will cause more absorption of the light, and it will cause less light to allow less light to pass through the lenses. But in the photochromatic, means in the Polaroid, what happens is like polychromatic, in the Polaroid lenses, the tint is fixed. And the another thing is like absorptive lenses is not a good means ideal thing to use in the disability glare or blinding glare. Okay, in that conditions, only the polarized lenses can be work well. Okay, so what you can think of one is like all the Polaroid lenses are the absorptive lenses, but not all the absorptive lenses are Polaroid lenses. So Polaroid lenses and absorptive lenses, the common things is like they both can block the UV, but they both cannot be the ideal to use in the glare condition. Absorptive lenses, definitely according to the intensity, it can be used as a means if it is too dark, or if the intensity of the tint is too high, then it can definitely block the glare. But for some condition, like in the snow or in the skiing or in the high intensity of the glare, at that time only the Polaroid lens works actually. So this is the two different things and two different conditions of this Polaroid lenses. Actually, what I want to tell is like Polaroid lenses is not, means people are very like fancy to use the Polaroid lenses, but it's not very useful for us in a condition where there is like low light or not very high intensity of exposure in the glare and all. You can simply use the tinted lenses or any absorptive lenses, means any form of the tinted lenses. But Polaroid lenses are highly recommended for those who works near the sea or in the mountain area where there will be the snow, or those walks where there will be the high amount of the reflection coming from a building or any snow surface or any like what you call plane mirror or something like that. Okay, so polarized lenses are specifically used in that condition, but objective lenses, this is a this can be used in the day-to-day general purpose while going outside. Okay, so polarized lenses are not mandatory to be used everywhere, but what we need to keep in mind is like polarized lenses is a good source of UV blocker. But
Miss Ankita Mishra asks, difference between blue cut and photochromatic lenses.
There are a huge difference between blue cut and the photochromatic lenses. So blue cut is basically, it casts the blue light and the means the wavelength of around like 380 to 450 nanometer. Okay, so this is the specifically means the lenses which will be using for blocking those amount of the wavelength of the light which causes harm to our eyes. But photochromatic lenses are basically the lenses which are used for the outside exposure in the sunlight, which is basically used for blocking the UV, and another thing is like to absorb the intensity of the light. Okay, the higher the amount of the UV there will be, the more it will turn dark and it will cause the block the lens, UV. Okay, but blue light is completely different. Blue light, blue cut lenses or blue filter lenses are completely used indoor purpose, but photochromatic lenses is mostly used in the outdoor purpose. There's a major difference actually, blue cut lenses. But it can be like photochromatic and blue cut both mix, which can give you both, which can solve you both purpose. Outside it can be photochromatic, so for our outdoor activities it's a good choice, and for indoor if there is already blue cut, then it can be for dual purpose actually.
Miss Anita Porel asks, does polarized lens eliminate all types of glare, or it only eliminate reflective glare?
See, like definitely, as I told, there are different types of the glare which I have mentioned here. Okay, so that if you see this, like there is something called as distracting glare. So distracting glare cannot be eliminated by the what you call polarized lenses. And for the discomfort glare, definitely you can use these polarized lenses for outdoor activities. So discomfort glare, disability glare, and this blinding glare all can be prevented from the polarized lenses. But this distracting glare, which is caused due to the like internal ghost images, as I told, or internal reflections from the lenses or backside of the lenses, which cannot be eliminated by the polarized lenses. It is only eliminated by the anti-reflection coated lenses.
Thank you for the answers, sir. We are done with the questions now. And on behalf of our Optum team and our audience, I'd like to thank you for giving your time, knowledge, and the lovely experience. I just request you to share your experience on today's session.
Yeah, means I was not expecting this many questions actually. So it was really an interactive one. Though I cannot see anyone, from the video, or I cannot see the chat and all. But I'm really honored to give little bit of my knowledge to all the audience, and I could not get much feedback from them. There were only the questions. So if anyone can help me or add more points, whatever I have kept here, it will be really helpful. And even like anybody want to put some more things, more added information, they can be in touch with me. But I really appreciate for Optum and you especially taking this effort of like letting people know about different topics of the optometry and eye care field. Thank you so much for this opportunity. It was a wonderful experience.
Thank you for your kind words, sir. And I would like to thank audience too for being supportive, interactive, and being with us till the end of the session. This brings us to the end of the session. We will be back with more programs and sessions. So further updates, stay tuned with us. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.